गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स, चैप्टर नंबर 8 क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. ओके, इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्वाड्रिलेटरल एंड टाइप्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल एंड देयर प्रॉपर्टीज. सो फर्स्टली लेट अस सी व्हाट इज अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज अ फोर साइडेड फिगर विच हैज फोर एंगल्स एंड फोर वर्टिसेस. ओके, क्लोज्ड पॉलीगन यू कैन से ऑफ फोर साइड्स, दैट इज क्वाड्रिलेटर. देन एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ए क्वाड्रिलेटर. एज वी नो इन अ ट्राइंगल सम ऑफ थ्री एंगल्स इज 180. इन अ क्वाड्रिलेटर देयर आर फोर एंगल्स एंड सम ऑफ दैट फोर एंगल्स इज 360 डिग्री. देन टाइप्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटर. फर्स्ट इज अ स्क्वेयर. अ स्क्वेयर इज अ क्वाड्रिलेटर विद ऑल इक्वल साइड्स एंड ईच एंगल 90 डिग्री. ए बी सी डी इज अ स्क्वेयर इन विच ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी सी इज इक्वल टू सी डी इज इक्वल टू डी ए एंड ईच एंगल ए बी सी डी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. आफ्टर दैट सेकेंड टाइप, दैट इज रेक्टेंगल. रेक्टेंगल इज अ क्वाड्रिलेटर इन विच अपोजिट साइड्स आर equal and each angle is 90 degree. Here ABCD is a rectangle with AB is equal to DC, AD is equal to BC and each angle is 90 degree. Third type is rhombus. Rhombus is a quadrilateral in which all sides are equal. Now see the students, square and rhombus, in both all sides are equal, but the difference is in square each angle is 90 degree, but in rhombus angle may or may not 90. Okay, then parallelogram. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which opposite sides are equal and parallel. AB equal to CD and AB parallel to CD. Now same we have done in rectangle, that opposite sides are equal, but the difference is in rectangle each angle is 90 and in parallelogram each angle is not 90. So you can say if each angle of parallelogram becomes 90, then it will become a rectangle. Next is a trapezium. Trapezium is a quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite side is parallel. You can see ABCD trapezium where AB is parallel to CD but AD is not parallel, only one pair is parallel. Next is kite shape. All of you have seen the kite, so one that is also quadrilateral. What is a kite shape? A kite shape is that quadrilateral in which adjacent sides are equal. Here AD is equal to AB and BC is equal to CD. This is the kite shape. Okay, so these are the six types of quadrilaterals. Now from all these six types we will start with parallelogram. In our first exercise we will do the questions and theorems related to properties of parallelogram. So let us start. First property is a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. This is the property of parallelogram which we will solve here, prove here as a theorem. First theorem, we have given a parallelogram ABCD and one diagonal AC. We have to prove that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADC. So let us see how to do. Here when ABCD is a parallelogram, it means AD parallel BC and AB parallel DC. AC is transversal. So when this line is parallel to this line and this is the transversal, we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2, alternate anterior angle. And when these two are parallel, then we can say 3 is equal to 4, alternate interior angle. Okay, so right here angle 1 is equal to 2, angle 3 is equal to 4. Why? Reason is alternate interior angles. Okay, alternate interior angles are equal and this side AC is equal to AC. This is common. So by angle side angle criteria, triangle ADC is congruent to CBA. Why? Angle side angle. This we want to prove, that diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles, and we have proved here. Once again see, here we have given a parallelogram ABCD and AC is diagonal. So here we have taken alternate interior angle, 1 is equal to 2, 3 is equal to 4, and then we have taken third AC is equal to AC common. By angle side angle, triangles are congruent. Okay, this was the first property of a parallelogram. Now second property, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. This we know, but here we want to prove. So as in first question, in first theorem we have proved that triangle ADC congruent to CBA, same up to here we will do, and then we will write AB is equal to DC, BC is equal to AD. Why? By CP CT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Firstly, you will solve theorem 1 up to here, and then you will add these two lines, that AB is equal to DC and BC is equal to AD by CPCT. Okay, so two theorems we have done. Next, third theorem is, if each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then prove that it is a parallelogram. We have to prove opposite sides of a parallelogram equal and quadrilateral equal, prove that it is a parallelogram. Now students, you can see here, when we have given these opposite sides are parallel, okay, and we can take this diagonal is common, so by side triangle will be congruent. Then you can take this angle is equal to this angle, and angle ACD is equal to angle CAB by CPCT, but these are alternate interior angle. It means AB is parallel to CD. Now when one pair of opposite side is parallel and equal, that is a parallelogram. Okay, so you will do up to theorem 8.3. You will try these three theorems and read out all the concepts. If any problem is there, then discuss with me in Zoom session. Okay, thank you.